Dissection in first year is one of the most memorable experiences in medical school for every medical student. Did medical students in the ancient era also had to perform dissection like us? If so, how? When did the practice start? Were they also irritated by the smell of formalin? Did they use scalpel forceps like us or other instruments? Let us find in the video. Dissection of human bodies for learning anatomy had been practiced in India for over 3000 years. References of selection of dead body for dissection, preservation, methods of performing and importance of dissection can be found in the Sanskrit medical text, the Sushruta Samhita, which is estimated to be written between 1500 and 1000 BC. Can you imagine? 3 millennium ago, when most of the people had been living just from hand to mouth, medical science was so advanced that dissection, surgical and parasurgical procedures were performed, and that too in a very scientific manner. Among the 186 chapters of the Sushruta Samhita, the reference is found in the shloka number 47, 48, 49 of the 67th chapter named Sharira Sankhya Vyakaranam Sharir. At first, Maharshi Sushruta mentions the necessity of dissection, that is, Shavachedan Mahatva. Tasmat Nihisamshayam Jnanam Hartra Shalyasya Vanchata Shodhayitva Mritam Samyak Drishtavyo Anga Vinishrayaha. It means, one who is desirous of acquiring a thorough knowledge of anatomy and surgery should prepare a dead body and carefully observe and examine the different parts after proper dissection. Pratyakshato hi yad drishtam, shastra drishtam cha yad bhavet. Samasat tasmat ubhayam bhuyo jnana vivardhanam. This can be translated as, the knowledge increases. Or thorough knowledge can be obtained only by combining the knowledge acquired by reading books with that obtained by direct personal observation or doing practically. Then comes the selection criteria of the dead body to be dissected. Tasmat samasta gatram avishopahatam adirgha vyadhi piditam avarsha shatika. Which means the dead body of a person who had all the body parts intact, did not die from poisoning or chronic disease, and less than 100 years of age should be selected for dissection. Then, purification, preservation, preparation of the dead body for dissection, that is, sangrakshan evam sangshodhan. Nihisrishtantra purisham purusham avahantyabhagayam nibaddham panjarastham munjavalkala kushashanadinam anyatamena veshtita anga pratyangam aprakashadeshe kothayet. The excreta should be removed from the entrails and the body should be left for decomposition in a slow-flowing water body after placing the body in a cage wrapped completely with sheets of plants, munja, kusha, shana, etc. Samyak prakuthitam cha udhritya tato deham saptaratrat ushir bala valkala kurchanam anyatamena shanaihi shanaihi avagharshayan stvat adin sarvaneva bahya abhyantara anga pratyanga visheshan yathoktan lakshet chakshusha. After 7 days, the body kept in the solitary water body would be properly decomposed. The body should be taken out and unwrapped. Then the observer should slowly scrape off the skin with a whisk made of grass roots, hair, kusha blade or with a strip of split bamboo and carefully observe with his own eyes all the external and internal organs as mentioned in the theory books. So, this was the direct Sanskrit reference and its English translation. Now a brief interpretation of the procedure. The importance of dissection mentioned by Maharshi Sushrut is not different from what our anatomy professors keep us saying. The selection procedure is to ensure that the observer does not get affected from the dead body and each and every structure is properly observed. The preservation method is different from what is in practice nowadays. The body is wrapped in some medicinal plants and put inside a cage. The reason behind this process might be to prevent the body from being destroyed by aquatic animals, and the plants might have exerted some antimicrobial actions. The water body should be away from human habitations so that locals are not affected. This technique had its own advantages, such as the structures become soft after remaining immersed in water for 7 days, thereby making the dissection easy, and every minute structures become visible after swelling in water, which otherwise would not have been visible. For dissection, sharp and blunt instruments made of hard structures of plants were used, like scalpels, forceps, scissors, etc. we use today. So wasn't it interesting to know how our ancestors used to perform dissection thousands of years back? If you found the video informative, click the like button, and for more informative videos, click the subscribe button. Sarve Niramaya Santu.